when it comes to his memos, for heaven's sake, we have been asking for those memos in Congress. Comey's out there lying about them. McCabe got all these people talking about them, yet he won't even let us have them in Congress. That's got to change. We've got to have those memos, period.
Yeah, well, I mean, I don't know what you're going to do to get them. I mean, you know, clearly Bob Goodlatte of the Judiciary Committee, your colleague, has been actually subpoenaed for the 1.2 million documents to Rod Rosenstein. And that's like, you know, the subpoena a couple of weeks ago comes on another subpoena a year ago from Jason Chaffetz. And they've been stonewalling you for a year. So I don't know why all of a sudden they would get religion and send you the memos now. I mean, what... You know, your colleagues, Bob Goodlatte, have said, if we don't get the memos, we will hold them in contempt of Congress. So what does that mean? Right. That eventually means impeachment. Are you ready to go the whole way here and impeach senior levels of the Department of Justice? That includes Rod Rosenstein, doesn't it?
Yeah. Well, Rosenstein could very well be under investigation. A full investigation into the Uranium One, which he supervised, which he soft-pedaled to allow Hillary to have the get her colleagues to approve the sale of uranium to Russia through Uranium One. So I have no problem with impeaching Rosenstein. He is a problem. He needs to step down, but he's not going to because he's got to cover for himself and for Mueller in the uranium investigation. So, and listen, let me make clear, Maria, this would not be like a contempt under Boehner. Boehner didn't want to hold anybody in contempt until he found out we could vote on contempt and nothing would happen. You have to not only vote on contempt, which I feel like we would pass that, but then you take it to court and you get a judge to put people in jail if that's what's necessary to enforce the contempt. And I think people are ready to do that
now. It's pretty extraordinary that you've got three Republican committee chairmen, including Bob Goodlatte, Trey Gowdy, you know, the chairman of the House Judiciary Committee, the chairman of the Oversight, chairman of the Intel, demanding all of these copies of the Comey memos. Here's what your colleague Goodlatte told me yesterday on this subject.
We're looking to receive the unredacted Comey memos so that we have the opportunity to see what Mr. Comey is telling the people in his book compared to what is occurring in terms of his recounting of his meeting with the president.
So, Congressman, here you've got this request for the documents, which we've talked about. You've got the IG report that I have right here that was dropped, well, the beginning of the IG report, which was dropped on Friday night about Andrew McCabe, where he lied four times, three times under oath. And you've got Bob Goodlatte saying this could actually go all the way up to the Obama White House. And a former FBI director on a book tour trashing the president. I mean, it's quite extraordinary.
That is unbelievable. It really is unbelievable. It also tells you about the lack of common sense that Comey has. Good grief. This guy admitted to leaking under oath. In order to manipulate things to get a special counsel, he has got problems. But how ironic. He's out there doing a book tour talking about his memos, as is everybody else, but McCabe won't even let us have, Ray will not even let us have the memos. So we hope to move forward. And they've got it. Ray needs to understand, this is not a John Boehner threat on contempt. This is Bob Goodlatte. It's a very serious threat, and we intend to do something about it. But Comey's lawyers have got to be really just cringing because everything he say can come back to bite him. It can be used against him. So he's really, I can't imagine a lawyer's nightmare any more than Comey out there just yapping away.
Right, because we know that there's another part of the Inspector General report that's coming out within a month.
That's right.
That's going to zero in on Comey, and it's going to zero in on the FBI's handling of the email scandal for Hillary Clinton. Let me ask you before you go, Congressman, part of the Freedom Caucus, we want to know your thoughts on the next Speaker of the House. We know that Paul Ryan is stepping down. Who are you supporting for the next Speaker?
Well, the Freedom Caucus, we're looking at it. We're talking about it. But we've got to have somebody that is going to help the president keep his promise. We need somebody that didn't run against the president's promises, but somebody who kept them. I would prefer if they were here in 08, they didn't vote for TARP. I've got many of my friends that say, if you voted for that outrageous omnibus, you shouldn't be speaker.
Wow. All right, Congressman. Thank you. Louie Gohmert.